My name is Michael Lucas, and I'm a writer and script producer of season 4. This season I've written episodes 3 and 4 and 8, and 11 is my last episode of the season. Episode 11 begins with a dream sequence, and in the dream, it's kind of like a gorging dream where Nina's doing everything wrong in terms of being pregnant. She's smoking, she's drinking, she's eating sushi and soft cheeses, and she's behaving very, very badly. And the dream plays out like a rap video, like one of those rap videos that's focuses on a very, very bad girl having a big night. The idea for doing this dream sequence came pretty early in the plotting for the season, because we knew we wanted to touch upon the kind of health kick that pregnant women have to be on, and the lifestyle changes, which is such a big part of being pregnant these days. But it's about finding ways to do it that are fun and distinctive. And I'd heard about women who have been so health conscious during their pregnancy that they actually have dreams or nightmares where they're doing everything wrong. And instantly in plotting, we thought, oh, that'd be great territory for Nina, considering dreams and fantasies are such a big part of it. So we're sort of locked in that we might do something like that from an early stage. And then sort of about a month into it, I had the idea of presenting that like a rap video. And then as soon as I thought of that, it suddenly seemed like this big treat that I couldn't wait to write. And I actually saved it to my last episode of the season as like a, you know, as like something fun for me to do. And for the whole crew to do on my last block. But it could have fallen at any time. It was definitely one of those things that seemed like a good idea at the start, and it was just waiting for the right moment to pull it out. And also a great way to start an episode. It's always... One thing that I love about Offspring is throwing the audience into this completely unusual place early on, and then out of the credits, they have to sort of find their feet back in the world again. One of the best parts of the process for me was that normally I have very little to do with the composer, John Lee. I'm at the very beginning of the process and he's at the very end. But in this instance, I came to him well before pre and explained the concept of the song, and it was the first time ever that we've been able to really collaborate on something. And thankfully, he was really excited about it right from the word go. And he too was looking up all these references and sending them through. And probably the absolute high point was when we had Asher and then the nurses in his home studio, and I was there adjusting the lyrics or coming up with new lyrics, and he was there recording the track and making adjustments. It was really, really collaborative and fun. And a few of the best parts of the song, like the bridge of Bounce Baby Bounce to Your Waters Break, was just an idea that came up in the room, us all working together. And it sort of makes me want to do more musical sequences so that I can collaborate with him and involve him, because it was a huge amount of fun, and he seemed to understand the intent of it really, really clearly. So I hadn't forewarned Asher that I had written this rap, so I knew that when she got the script for episode 11, she was just going to read it and have a reaction to it. And Asher is one of the things I love about working with her, is that she's so game, she's up for anything. But I thought, for anyone, this might test them. The idea that she has to dance around like an idiot, heavily pregnant, smoking and drinking and gyrating against men. And so I was holding my breath when she got that script. But then thankfully, instantly, she was up for it. And if anything, she was just very, very determined to get it right and for it to not sound stupid. She really wanted to go in there and rap well and dance well, and she was as rigorous and as committed to it as she's, you know, with any other aspect of playing the part of Nina. And it came off so well that now the only thing for me is just to try and think of something for next season that's going to top it in some way. But I think I'd be lucky to come up with something more extreme or out there than this one.